Hi there guys, I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology.
And I'm Meg, the acoustic specialist at our PMT Portsmouth store.
And I've got a question for you today, Meg.
Yep.
Roland acoustic amps sound absolutely great, don't they?
Yes, they do.
And we both love the Boss VE8 Acoustic Singer pedal.
Yep.
But I've been thinking, why haven't Roland and Boss thought to combine these two fantastic products into a great sounding, easy to use, compact amplifier?
Well, funny you should say that, Sam, because they just have.
Well, that's convenient. Should we take a look? So today we're looking at the Boss Acoustic Singer Pro and the Acoustic Singer Live, two great new acoustic amps designed with vocalists in mind. The Acoustic Singer Live offers 60 watt output and features a 6.5-inch woofer and a dome tweeter, whilst its bigger brother, the Acoustic Singer Pro, offers 120 watt output and has got an 8-inch driver and again a dome tweeter. These amps feature a bi-amp design, which means that the woofer and the tweeter are amplified completely separately, offering greater clarity and maximum volume. Other than that, the features on both amps are exactly the same. So let's take a look at the control panel. The Boss Acoustic Singer amps feature two individual channels, one for vocals and one for guitar. So let's take a look at the vocal channel. First up, we've got a dual XLR jack input, allowing you to use either balanced or unbalanced cables. There's a 48 volt phantom power switch for if you're using a condenser microphone. And there's also a pad switch, which attenuates the input volume, depending on the output power of your microphone. There's standard controls for volume, bass, middle and treble, and there's an anti-feedback circuit. This allows you to dial in and notch out any pesky frequencies, which when combined with the phase reverse switch, means that you shouldn't ever experience any feedback problems when using one of these amps. The vocal channel also features some built-in effects. You've got a choice of either delay or echo, and then there's an overall reverb. These are really easy to use. You simply dial in the amount of the effect that you want to apply to the vocal channel. Let's take a listen and see how that sounds.
There is a house down in New Orleans. They call the rising sun. It's been the ruin of many a poor boy and me. Oh God, I'm one. Well, my mother was a tailor. She sewed these new blue jeans. My father was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Now the only thing a gambler needs is a suitcase and a trunk. And the only time he's satisfied is when he's on a drunk.
Finally on the vocal channel is a harmonist. This allows you to select either a high or low harmony or a unison doubler effect and can be switched in and out either from the front panel or via an optional foot switch. You can control the volume of the harmony and rather cleverly the amp selects the harmony note depending on the guitar chord that you're playing. It works really well and adds that extra layer of colour for a solo vocalist. Take a listen and see what I mean.
You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you just might find you get what you need. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometimes, you just might find you get what you need. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. You can't always get what you want. But if you try sometime, you just might find you get what you need.
Next up, let's move on to the guitar channel. It's very similar to the vocal channel, with a pad attenuator switch, volume, bass, middle and treble controls, and that same anti-feedback circuit. The guitar channel also features a reverb and two different types of chorus. The first chorus is very natural sounding, whereas the second one has a much deeper modulation, offering a bigger and wider sounding effect. There's also an acoustic resonance switch. When using a piezo pickup, you do tend to lose a lot of the natural sound of your guitar. The acoustic resonance feature attempts to restore some of that natural warmth, body and resonance to your tone. So let's take a listen to the acoustic resonance and the chorus in action. Both the Acoustic Singer Pro and the Acoustic Singer Live also feature onboard loopers, offering 40 seconds looping time with unlimited overdubs. Just like the Harmonist, they can be controlled either from the front panel or via an external foot switch. They're really simple to use. Press the loop button once to start recording, a second time to enter playback mode, and a third time to start overdubbing. The stop button stops the loop, but press and hold it for 2 seconds and it'll clear all of those recordings so you can start again.
Your love gets sweeter every day. 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 Your love gets...
Finally, on the front panel, there's a master volume, a mute button, and a tweeter attenuator switch. So let's take a look at the back of the amp. The rear panel features a pretty comprehensive I/O. There's a pair of balanced XLR outputs for connecting to a PA system. These can either be used as a left and right mixed output of everything that's going through the amplifier, or they can be switched to offer separate individual outputs for both the microphone and guitar channel, either with the effects applied or as a straight dry DI'd output. There's an auxiliary input for connecting something like an MP3 player, foot switch connections for controlling the looper, the harmonist and the chorus effects, a headphones and line output, and a USB recording output. So these amps can actually be used as a basic USB recording interface. As with all Boss products, the Acoustic Singers are really well made and sturdy for gigging. Considering their output powers, they're quite compact and not too heavy, and they look great in this dark wood finish. So now I'm going to hand you back over to Meg, who's going to play you one of her songs utilising a few of the features on the Boss Acoustic Singer Pro. Enjoy.
The little boy they see should have been. The river valleys and streams running free. And do you know, we're letting people go just to pave the way for our mistakes. 'Cause what if the world starts spinning? The only way I want to know. And follow, let the little boy grow old. And don't go in the steps of the ones before. They didn't see, and they've left it all to me. 'Cause what if the world starts spinning? Would we see what we've done? What if the world stopped moving? It's the only way I want to go. The only way I want to know.
So that was the Boss Acoustic Singer Live and Acoustic Singer Pro. For more information, visit www.pmtonline.co.uk and follow us on Facebook, facebook.com/PMT House of Rock.
Or better still, pop into your local professional music technology. We have stores dotted all over the UK. I'm the acoustic specialist at the PMT Portsmouth store. There's someone like me at every store 7 days a week to give you any advice or help that you might need.
So make sure to follow your local PMT on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram to keep up to date with all the latest products, special offers, news and events.
If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more like this.
And I'm going to embarrass Meg a little bit now. But as you've just heard, she's a really talented singer-songwriter. And if you want to hear more, check out our website, www.meganlinford.co.uk. She's been Meg.
He's been Sam.
And we'll see you next time.